رب العالمين. And alhamdulillah, still we are in our journey with Surah Fussilat. And alhamdulillah, رب العالمين, that we have reached to the chapter number 41, where we talk about the verses of Allah, the Quran, the words of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, which is when Allah described the verses of the Quran, Allah said, Fussilat ayatuhu. And Fussilat means, Fussilat, clearly explained, right? And it's different than the word Uhkimat, because you have Uhkimat ayatuhu. Uhkimat ayatuhu, the rough translation to be stitched together, perfectly stitched together, connected together. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in Surah Fussilat, we talked about what was the main theme of the surah, if you still remember. Then what's the main theme?
Oh,
huh? Auntie Mary. Yes, exactly. And how we connect ourselves to the book of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That's the main theme of the entire chapter of Surah Fussilat. And do you remember the story of Utbah? We talked about Utbah when he came to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and he came with an offer. And he said, if you want the kingdom, if you want to be the king, we will elect you as our king. If you want money, we will do fundraising and we will collect all our money, our gold, and we'll give it to you. If you want authority, whatever you want. If you want to get married, we will bring like 10 women so you can choose whatever you want. Whatever you want, but we want one thing, to stop promoting that religion, to stop your campaign in delivering the religion of Islam. And Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam did not speak from his own. He spoke from the verses of Surah Fussilat. It has the response from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And to be honest with you, that response took almost like 2 pages of the surah to give the full response to Utbah. Now you came with an offer to the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, trying to stop him from conveying the da'wah, try to stop the religion of Allah, and you forgot that there is a creator, and the one who sent him is the creator subhanahu wa ta'ala. Then the message came, and I wanted you to listen to this message. So imagine this is Utbah standing in front of Rasulullah, listening to the message directly from Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So what was the message? Qul, you know qul means say. Means everything will come after. Rasulullah got a command from Allah to say that statement. Not to increase a letter, not to miss a letter. Like qul huwa Allahu ahad. Allahu samad. Some people will say, why Allah said qul? Allah could say easily, Allahu ahad, without qul, without say, O Muhammad, say Allahu ahad. Because we must know that this is a message from Allah to the Prophet to say it. So that's not the word of Rasulullah, it's the words of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. These are the words of our Creator. So Allah said, قُلْ أَإِنَّكُمْ لَتَكْفُرُونَ بِالَّذِي خَلَقَ الْأَرْضَ فِي يَوْمَيْنِ وَتَجْعَلُونَ لَهُ أَنْدَادًا ذَلِكَ رَبُّ الْعَالَمِينَ. Are you going to disbelieve in Allah, the one who created earth in 2 days, and now you are trying to make andadan to him? You are trying to make partners with him, but partners, this is a word related to shirk, right? But what is andadan? Andadan, this is a plural word. The singular word is nid. What is nid? When you have a person head to head to somebody, like something you think it is equivalent to Allah, something can compete with Allah, Allah said, are you making those idols to act, to look like ند, like competitors to Allah? ذلك رب العالمين. He is Allah, the master of everything. وجعل. But now, what's the information we got? 2 days that Allah had created the earth in 2 days. وجعل فيها رواسي من فوقها. And he created mountains to make that earth stable. وبارك فيها. And give land, massive lands that's so extended. وقدر فيها أقواتها. He blessed this land and he determined its sustenance. وقدر فيها أقواتها. Please, please, sisters in the back. Sisters in the back, please. وقدر فيها أقواتها means Allah had determined its sustenance. The sustenance of earth, the plants, animals, insects, and all the creation of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah had determined previously, before the creation of Adam, even the little drop that will come from rain that will go to a certain plant and it will produce a certain flower, it is determined even before the creation of the human beings. وَقَدَّرَ فِيهَا أَقْوَاتَهَا. So now, earth in 2 days, and the mountains, and the sustenance, the determination of all of this, it took how long? 4 days. فِي أَرْبَعَةِ أَيَّامٍ سَوَاءً لِلسَّائِلِينَ. And Allah had granted justice, equality for all. And listen to this. Now 2 days for the creation of earth and 4 days for the determination of the destiny of Allah, of the sustenance of the creation of Allah. And now we have 6 days. What about sky? Then Allah, the next verse, give you the answer. ثم استوى إلى السماء. And now he directed himself to the sky. وَهِيَ دُخَانٌ. It was, the skies were in a state of smoke. وَهِيَ دُخَانٌ. And by the way, we have the chapter of الدخان, Surah الدخان. وَهِيَ دُخَانٌ. Allah directed himself means he subhanahu wa ta'ala started to look at or give attention to the skies. And now here Allah did not mention time frame for the skies. So the scholar said, so the 2 days were for the earth and the skies. Simultaneously, Allah worked in the creation of both. Like you have two projects in the same day, it's the same. So you have the earth and you have the skies. وَهِيَ دُخَانٌ. It was in a state of smoke, and Allah created the skies. Then Allah addressed the skies and earth. فَقَالَ لَهَا وَلِلْأَرْضِ. Allah said to the skies and earth, إِئْتِيَا. That's a command from Allah. إِئْتِيَا طَوْعًا أَوْ كَرْهًا. قَالَتَا أَتَيْنَا طَائِعِينَ. Allah gave the command to the earth, to the sky, to do what? To move. Come. Come before me. Move. Willingly or unwillingly. Means, even if you accept it or not, come willingly to Allah, or Allah will force you to move. And the scholar said, this is the moment that Allah had given the order to earth to go in motion. And from that moment, everything on this earth in motion, the galaxies and everything, So they were in a state of freezing. Then Allah said, move. And everything started to move from the little atom to the galaxies, the stars, the sun, and everything. And the skies and earth responded to Allah, قَالَتَ أَتَيْنَا طَائِعِينَ. We will come, we will move in full submission to you, O Allah. This is how the earth and the skies had responded. طائعين. We will be obedient. We will be submissive to you, O Allah. Then Allah said, فَقَضَاهُنَّ سَبْعَ سَمَاوَاتٍ فِي يَوْمَيْنِ. Allahu Akbar. Then Allah had created. Now you are confused about the 2 days. Imam, are you sure that the 2 days were for the two projects, earth and skies? This is the answer. The ayah number 12. Allah said, I had established, I had decreed, I had created 7 skies in these 2 days. وَأَوْحَى فِي كُلِّ سَمَاءٍ أَمْرَهَا. Then Allah gave the order, commanded every sky with its command, with its order. So now we can understand that the 7 skies, they are not working as one unit. Somehow, every sky has its own mission. And you might say, Imam, what does it mean? What is the mission of the first sky? Do you remember? Who memorizes Surah Al-Mulk? وَحَفِظْنَاهَا. It's decorating, and not only this, sending what? Building missiles, building the devils, the shayateen, that they used to go up to the sky so they can know some of the orders, the commands that Allah is giving to the angels. They wanted to hear some of the conversations between the angels so they can extract something about the upcoming, something about the future. Then Allah gave the order to the first sky to build those devils with the air strikes of Jahannam, of the fire. So this is one of the missions of the first sky. So Allah said, وَأَوْحَى فِي كُلِّ سَمَاءٍ أَمْرَهَا. He gave the order for each sky with specific command. Subhanallah. Then Allah said, وَزَيَّنَّ. We have decorated السَّمَاءَ الدُّنْيَا. And I want to explain something here. The first sky, the word sky means sama, right? Sama. And our life here, you have heard dunya, right? In Urdu, you have dunya, right? So Allah said, the first sky is called as-sama ad-dunya. What do you understand from this? Sama ad-dunya. The lowest sky. Because the word dunya comes from what? Dunu. Dunu, something very low. Our dunya means it's the lowest of the lowest. This is our dunya with all the billions and the cars and all of this technology. In our side, in Allah's side, in our side, it should be the lowest of the lowest. Because of what? Nothing would remain in this dunya. The whole dunya will be perished, will be demolished. Nothing would remain. It has no value in the sight of Allah. And that's why Allah said, if the whole dunya have the value or equals in the sight of Allah a wing of a mosquito, Allah would never give a sip of water to a disbeliever. So that means the entire dunya doesn't equal in the sight of Allah a wing of mosquito. Yes. And now, for those who went for ghusl, washed a body of a deceased, of a person who passed away, Just to tell you this, I was talking to my parents when they came here. I told them, you know, sometimes you feel you observe a person getting old because of a gray hair, but sometimes you become old without a gray hair. You become old with what you have seen in your life. So if, like for me, the first time I washed a body for a dead person, when I was in the high school. The first time I buried a person, when I was in the high school. From that time, you can imagine how many cases I have seen, how many graves I went to. And I come to the conclusion every time that wallahi, this dunya worth nothing. It worth nothing. When you see a young muscular guy, and I think the brothers had seen this recently in Ramadan, muscular guy, very strong, wide body, and subhanallah, and he's dead. You move his arm, you move his head, you move his leg, has no power, no might, nothing, nothing at all. We are cutting with the scissors his clothing. We take his wallet, the keys of his car, everything. What did he get from this dunya? Nothing. You ask yourself, when you wash the body like this, when you flip the body, when you wrap him in a very cheap shroud, and if you brought it expensive, the imam will reject it. By the way, if you got it made out of silk, it is haram. It is haram. So it has to be cheap. So that's all what you get from the dunya. And even that piece of, it will be rotten afterwards. And that's all. You got nothing from this dunya. And you ask yourself, is this the dunya that I kept fighting and disobeyed Allah for? Is it really deserve my fighting to be overwhelmed, to disobey Allah, to hate my brother in Islam, to have jealousy because of he got a new car and I didn't, to feel something bad in my heart? La wallahi. No, it doesn't work. To hate one another, you have brothers like blood relatives. They fight, they go to court. They fight one another, they hate one another. Maybe they are disconnected for 12, 15, 20 years because they were fighting for the inheritance of a couple of dollars. And the whole dunya doesn't work, doesn't deserve to hate one another like this. And you come, that's why visiting the graves, that will soften your heart. This is one of the reasons, washing the bodies, buying some shrouds, giving them as sadaqah for the sake of Allah. Keep yours in your house in front of your eyes. Hold it and say to yourself, I will be wrapped in this very soon. Remind yourself of the hereafter. So the whole dunya doesn't actually deserve. That's why the lowest sky got some of the features of this dunya. That's why it is called as-samaa ad-dunya, the lowest sky. Subhanallah, the lowest sky, as-samaa ad-dunya. Allah said, we have decorated as-samaa ad-dunya bimasabih, with lamps, the stars. وَحِفْظَ ذَلِكَ تَقْدِيرُ الْعَزِيزِ الْعَلِيمِ. This is the destiny of Allah, the one who has the absolute authority and knowledge. Then Allah said to Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, فَإِنْ أَعْرَضُ. Now who is listening to all these verses? What's his name? Utbah, the one who came with the offer to Rasulullah. He's listening to this, to all these verses. Allah now is giving a huge warning. فَإِنْ أَعْرَضُ فَقُلْ أَنذَرْتُكُمْ صَاعِقَةً مِثْلَ صَاعِقَةِ عَادٍ وَثَمُودٍ. If they have denied, if they objected, if they uttered one word against me or against this message, I warn you from a sa'iqah, from a punishment, as the punishment came to Ad and Thamud. Before I continue, I will tell you one of the narrations that narrated the reaction of Utbah. When Utbah reached to that ayah, he kept silent. Then Rasulullah continued almost one page. When Rasulullah finished, he didn't utter any word because he was afraid of the punishment of Allah. He went to his home and he didn't go to the marketplace. He didn't go to anyone. He didn't get mixed with anyone. And people thought that there is something bad happened. They went to his door. They knocked his door and they said, what happened to you? Did Muhammad say something wrong? He didn't respond. He was afraid to say a word, maybe understood or maybe explained as he is rejecting the message of Allah, then he will get the punishment immediately. And after 3 days, he came out to his people and he said, I couldn't utter one word because I was afraid to be included in the punishment of Allah. This man, Muhammad, if he said something or his God said something, it would definitely happen to us. This is Utbah. So who is Ad and Thamud? Do you remember Ad and Thamud? Ad, Iram Adhat al-Imad, right? Those who built gigantic palaces, massive buildings, like whatever we have, this building, whatever we have in 2024. What is the tallest building here in New York? The Empire? Huh? The World Trade Center. Yes, the new one. Okay. And before that was the Empire State, the building, right? Empire Building? Okay, so this is the highest. What if I told you that is nothing compared to what the people of Ad had built in their civilization? Imam, we are in the time of technology. Listen to the Quran. Allah said, "Allati lam yukhlaq mithluha fil bilad." Nothing can be compared. Nothing was created, nothing was done like the people of Ad before. You know, they used to yanhituna min al-jibali buyutan farihin. They used to make houses out of mountains. They used to carve mountains to make houses. Can you imagine? Not build over the mountains, no. The mountains itself, they used to make houses out of it. So they used to carve, they used to dig inside the mountains to make their houses. This is the people of Ad. Big pillars, palaces, massive buildings, tall buildings. What happened to them? Allah said, إِذْ جَاءَتْهُمُ الرُّسُلُ مِنْ بَيْنِ أَيْدِيهِمْ وَمِنْ خَلْفِهِمْ. Many messengers Allah had sent. Not only one. Yes, we know Hud alayhi salam. But Allah is telling us in Surah Fussilat, not only once, not only two. Allah said, رُسُل. Many messengers. They came with very simple message. أَلَّا تَعْبُدُوا إِلَّا اللَّهِ. Worship none except Allah. قالوا, what did they say? لو شاء ربنا, if Allah willed, he would send angels to us. So we are sure that he is the right, he is the true God. Then they said, even if he sent angels, we will disbelieve in your message. No way. So what did Allah say? Allah said, they were so arrogant with their power, with their might. I just wanted to ask you between the lines, do you know any of the nation nowadays so arrogant with their power and their might? Then you can fill the space. وَقَالُوا مَنْ أَشَدُّ مِنَّا قُوَّةً. And they said, who else can be stronger than us? They oppressed. And that's why nowadays we say the consequences of the oppression will come definitely. No nation had practiced this kind of oppression except that Allah demolished this nation. The people of Ad, they said, مَنْ أَشَدُّ مِنَّا قُوَّةً. Who is stronger than us on earth? Then Allah said, أَوَلَمْ يَرَوْا أَنَّ اللَّهَ الَّذِي خَلَقَهُمْ هُوَ أَشَدُّ مِنْهُمْ قُوَّةً. Aren't they know that Allah is the one who created them, has more power than them? Why did they forget Allah? Then what Allah said, فَأَرْسَلْنَا عَلَيْهِمْ. This is their punishment. رِيحًا صَرْصَرًا. I never see snow in my life. So who lived in states has snow? One, two, three, four. Okay, five, six, seven. Huh? What about you? And you never, okay. States, yeah, did you see snow before? In, yes, Auntie Marie. Okay, Allah said, I have sent for them riyah, wind, like hurricane, like tornado, sarsara, very cold, freezing, fi ayyamin nahisat, in a very cold days, for how long? 8 nights. 8 nights. سبع ليال وثمانية أيام حسوما. 8 days, 7 nights. Allah is sending tornado, freezing them. They shattered, they scattered because of the freezing, and that was their punishment. Allah said, we send that لنذيقهم عذاب الخزي في الحياة الدنيا. So we could humiliate them in this dunya. And what about the hereafter? And in the hereafter will be even worse. They will get the punishment of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So we give the, Allah is giving the example of Ad. And number two, Thamud. Allah said, وَأَمَّا ثَمُودُ. As for the people of Thamud, who is the messenger who was sent to Thamud? Sayyiduna Salih. The messenger of Allah, Salih. Salih was Arabi, right? Was Arabian. So, وَأَمَّا ثَمُودُ فَهَدَيْنَاهُمْ. Yes, we had guided them. فَاسْتَحَبُّ الْعَمَى عَلَى الْهُدَى. They loved the blindness over guidance. There is a metaphorical expression here. One of the meanings of guidance, Allah will open your eyes. You know, Quran takes you from darkness to light. And this is the guidance. And subhanAllah, Allah said in Surah An-Nahl about the people in the past who used to look at the stars, knowing they call them, they know their way, the skyway, or they know their way from the stars, right? The skyway. So Allah said, وَبِالنَّجْمِ, this is Surah An-Nahl, وَبِالنَّجْمِ هُمْ يَهْتَدُونَ. They are guided through the stars. And Allah said, Here it's the meaning of opening their eyes to know the direction. Allah said, the people of Thamud, although that they knew the right way, they opened their eyes to the truth of Allah, but they preferred blindness. They preferred the other way, to be shafted, to be moved to the way of the shaitan. فَاسْتَحَبُّ الْعَمَى عَلَى الْهُدَى. They preferred blindness over the guidance. What happened to them? فَأَخَذَتْهُمْ صَاعِقَةُ الْعَذَابِ الْهُونِ بِمَا كَانُوا يَكْسِبُونَ. Allah said, we have sent them the punishment, we belted them, we strike them with the thunder, with the severe punishment, which has the fire from Allah. So that's the extreme heat. And the other one was the extreme freezing and cold. And both of them were punishment from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And what happened to the disbelievers from that team and those team? Allah said, وَنَجَّيْنَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا وَكَانُوا يَتَّقُونَ. We have saved the believers from that team and that team. SubhanAllah. Now, before I wrap up the lecture, let me take you quickly to that scene that Allah said in this surah, because I want to move to another topic, not another surah, another topic, inshallah, tomorrow. Allah said, on the day of judgment, when they are getting together, all of them, all the creation of Allah, and they will be gathered together, when they come to the time, will be asked about their deeds, they will deny. Can you imagine someone in the presence of Allah, someone disobeyed Allah, and now he is standing before Allah. Allah will ask him, did you make that sin so and so? So some people would say, no. Allah, we didn't commit any sin. We were so innocent. We were angels. We were so good. They will deny. They will lie before Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah said, you know Surah Yasin? Okay. Who memorizes Surah Yasin? brother Abdul Basit. اليوم نختم على أفواههم وتكلمنا أيديهم وأرجلهم بما كانوا يعملون بما كانوا يكسبون. On that day, Allah will put a seal over their mouth. They wouldn't be able to talk. I don't know if you have seen some of the movies have almost the same ideology. Okay, recently, some of the movies, like The Matrix, I don't know if you have seen The Matrix before, they reached to that scene that somebody wanted to talk and there is a seal. What Allah said in the Quran 14 centuries ago, Allah said, we will put a seal over their mouth. And who is going to talk? Who is going to testify against them? As Dr. Rahim said last time, oh, يَوْمَ تَشْهَدُ عَلَيْهِمْ أي أَلْسِنَتُهُمْ وَأَيْدِيهِمْ وَأَرْجُلُهُمْ بِمَا كَانُوا يَعْمَلُونَ. And that day, Allah said, حَتَّى إِذَا مَا جَاءُوهَا شَهِدَ عَلَيْهِمْ سَمْعُهُمْ وَأَبْصَارُهُمْ وَجُلُودُهُمْ بِمَا كَانُوا يَعْمَلُونَ. Their hearings, their eyesight, their skin will testify against them. Did you make this? No, no. Oh Allah, I didn't look at this haram looking. So the mouth will be shut, will be closed, and the eye will talk. The eye will say, oh Allah, on that day, time so and so, yes, I looked at something haram. And they will talk. After Allah will allow them to talk, they will blame the eyes, they will blame the ears, they will blame the skin. وَقَالُوا لِجُلُودِهِمْ لِمَا شَهِدْتُمْ عَلَيْنَا. They said to their skin, why you have testified against us? Now you betray me? Your skin, your own ear, your own eye will testify against you? Yes. What did they say? The skin started to talk. قالوا أنطقنا الله الذي أنطق كل شيء. Allah is the one who ordered us to speak and we must obey Allah. This is your skin. And that's why, do not wonder if I told you your eyes can be your enemy on the day of judgment. Your ears can be your enemy. Allah said in the Quran, إِنَّمَا أَمْوَالُكُمْ وَأَوْلَادُكُمْ عَدُوًّا لَكُمْ فَاحْذَرُوهُمْ. Your wealth, your money, your children can be your enemy. So be aware. You know why? You're a child. You're a child. If somebody cheated, somebody stolen money to give education to his child, his child became doctor because of this money that he grabbed from haram. So Allah will ask the child, now you got your education from haram source. He will say, Allah, don't ask me. Don't blame me. Blame my father. Ah, I am the one who brought the money. So you can get your education and you will be a doctor. You will get money. You will have a good life. No, I didn't want this life because it was from the haram. Your child will say that to Allah. Allah, punish my father. He's the one who got the haram, not me. Your own child? Yes. And not only this. If Allah asked your child, why did you commit this haram thing? So and so. Why, for example, why did you take riba? Oh Allah, because I have my father next to me. He didn't cheat. He didn't teach me what's the meaning of riba. He taught me math, science, civics. He gave me everything. But when it came to the religion, he didn't tell me what is halal, what is haram. So, oh Allah, punish my dad. That's very fair. Yes, that's very fair. So be aware of this. May Allah guide us to the right path. Allahumma ameen. Ya Rabbil Alameen. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala protect us from the hellfire. Allahumma ameen. Surah Fussilat, still we have lots of good things, inshallah. We will talk. Have you heard about the term wali? Wali? Who's wali? Huh? Wali? A close servant of Allah? Okay. But in our modern life, who is wali? Not only that. Who is Mawlana? Leader. You see? Huh? Kadiwallah. Yes. Mawlana Kadiwallah. Astaghfirullah. Astaghfirullah. May Allah protect us. Ameen. The one who worships Allah. This is the issue that I'm going to address tomorrow. The two terms, Mawlana and Wali. Because we need to correct lots of things in our minds related to this. Who is the Wali of Allah? Waliullah. Who is the Wali of Allah? That's a very good question. Inshallah, tomorrow we'll try to give the answer for this. Yes. If you said what? No, that's it. That's it. No. You could be forgiven, inshallah. We ask Allah to forgive you. If you confessed, if you admitted your mistakes and Allah could forgive, Allah could punish you. But inshallah, we will make a dua that you will be forgiven. Inshallah. Don't worry. We'll make a dua. Inshallah. And if you got punished, do not call us. Okay? We cannot help. Okay. Jazakumullah khairan. Barakallahu feekum. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullah.